All right, so my name's Jake, and we're at a Chuck Dent Experience, and I'm glassing a board here in their factory. And it's a poly combination with EPS, epoxy resin. And I've been using this stuff, resin research, for about a year and a half, and cool. I find it's a good mixture.
Hey, shut the front door from the floor.
It doesn't matter what machine you have, okay? They generally take the stringers, their center point or the midline.
Yep.
But every machine, no matter what manufacturer it is, doesn't completely mirror it perfectly. So okay. If you took this board right here and you flipped it over, let's say, it's not gonna match.
Okay.
Right? There's always something different and off.
Yeah, this board is for my friend Cash. He's just learning to surf, and it has a lot of volume in it, and it's got a very flat rocker too, so it's a good board for beginners. It's a 510 by 19 and a half by 2.5, ending up to 34 liters, and you know, again, it's a poly blank, so it has a lot of density and it floats really well for him.
So did you mix up your resin?
Yeah. I got a stick in my car, but it's a big stick. Do you have a...
We'll get a popsicle sticker.
Mixing up some epoxy to set the fin boxes. So it's 50 and 25.
Yeah. You can take this brush,
okay,
and you're going to just put a little bit in, right?
Yeah.
Enough. Take the brush, you're gonna make sure you have enough in there to wet the whole thing out, right?
All right.
Like wet all parts of the foam.
Yeah.
Yeah, just go around and do the other two.
All right.
So when you put these things in, okay, some guys will do this and go forward. Just kind of put the front in first, right? Set it. And then just push in the back, right?
Okay.
Put your hand underneath, support the board, use your palm, right? Use your fingertips, you'll dent it, okay? Make sure the resin comes through each of the pools, and then remember, we're gonna splay it inwards, right?
Yeah.
Because remember the angles that we had set? So that's what we're gonna do. So go ahead and set your other pins. Just now on the side, right?
Hits that.
Make sure it's flush, right? Top to bottom?
Yeah.
So if it's not, pull it in just a touch more. If it's not, just push it out. Right there. Now go ahead and look at your trailer.
Yeah.
Look at your trailer from the nose.
So you can make sure it's straight.
So you can always vanishing point it too, right? So you lift your board up and you would look at it and you just sort of drop it down. Sometimes the reason why these fins are dummy fins is because they're off.
Pop it and then you'll need to squeeze that to get the foam.
Okay, take that off.
So I just set these fin box angles to 6.5 degrees on both the outer rail fins, and on the center it's at 0, so it'll have an equal amount of drive and power and speed. So yeah, that's about it. It's like a burning sensation on your hands with acetone. I didn't even know you could put acetone on your hands, you know? I thought it was dangerous, but apparently not. That you're supposed to set futures with jigs, not a... I thought it was just FCS, because futures actually have the angle built into the fin, where FCS is always 0 degrees, and then you have to tilt it and tape it off.